Well, Vice Presidential nominee Tim Walz doesn't exactly exude alpha male energy, and his weekend hunting trip hasn't helped.
No, Walz looked more like Elmer Fudd than a real shooter, which, let's be honest, is probably a good thing based on this vision.
Quite very, and it never fits quite right.
It never fits quite right. Just not quite right. How do you give it back?
Governor, what kind of gun is it?
This is a Beretta A400. I bought it when I was shooting a lot of trap. Because it has a kind of their patented thing, a kickoff.
There are no words. Joining us now is journalist and commentator Brad Polumbo. Brad, thanks for your time. This guy boasts about his extensive military experience, but he handles a gun like it's a foreign object that just fell from outer space.
I don't know that... I'm not sure I believe that he's ever touched a gun before in his life. I mean, I'm sure he has, but he looked so uncomfortable and the whole thing is so fake and so staged. I just can't help but feel like the Harris-Waltz campaign is just pandering to men in the most cheesy and cringeworthy way imaginable. Oh, well, we need this Midwestern guy to go on a hunt and stage a little photo shoot because that's what men like. No, I mean, the reason they're struggling with male voters is so much bigger than that. It's because the Democratic Party has spent years at this point just throwing men under the bus and stigmatizing masculinity and pushing ridiculous arguments like believing all women no matter what and so many other things that have isolated male voters. Putting Tim Walz in a cringeworthy and stilted hunting photo shoot is not going to help these people because they don't even know why they're in trouble with male voters in the first place.
Well, this is the funniest part out of all of this, Brad, is that, you know, this guy can't even handle a gun. Now he's been put in front of male voters. He's been tasked with trying to woo them over. I mean, Kamala Harris has rolled him out, said try and woo male voters because they've got a polling deficit among young men. I mean, we can hardly see why. Brad, how will Walz even be capable of turning that around, do you think?
He's not capable of it. He's simply not. I think you can tell that by the way that this rollout of the Tim Walz for male voters campaign is going. It's just cringeworthy. I mean, this guy, if you remember, has a really troubling record as a governor. He basically let his city, parts of it, be burned to the ground during the Black Lives Matter riots. He was one of the most dystopian and authoritarian COVID-19 governors in the entire United States. But they think because he's kind of folksy and they can put him in a hunting vest that male voters will just be emasculated and vote for him because he desperately panders to them. It's honestly kind of insulting. I mean, do they really think so little of men that they think they're that easily pandered to and won over by cheap gimmicks and photo ops? I mean, it's really quite something.
I just love that Politico headline, Tim Walz to woo male voters. I can't wait to be wooed by Tim Walz. If he wants to identify with American men, he should probably just vote for Trump. Yeah. Hey, speaking of whom, Brad, I want to get your thoughts on an art exhibit in LA that purports to protest against all the hate coming from Donald Trump. But get this, visitors are invited as part of this display to protest hate. They're invited to kick a replica of Donald Trump's head. I guess there's no better way to oppose hate than to make a replica of someone's decapitated head and kick it around.
This is sick. This is demented. What is going on in our country that people could actually do this unironically and think that this is somehow okay to do or that in this in any way is anti-hate? Yeah, I'm so anti-hate. I'm going to go kick around something that resembles the head of the person I despise. What? The cognitive dissonance on display here is astounding, but it really honestly makes me sad because when I was growing up, America was very much a country where people had the ethos of, I might disagree with what you have to say, but I'll defend to the death your right to say it. And, you know, we might not agree politically, we might vote for different people, but we're neighbors and friends and you can still be a good person. That really does seem to be going the way of the dodo bird, at least among some people, especially on the progressive left. And that's just really sad because the people who think they're the tolerant and open-minded ones, well, not only are they so open-minded now that in many cases their brain appears to have fallen out, they also don't seem so tolerant at all anymore when it comes to the people who disagree with them. And it's really sad and frankly un-American.